Assalamu alaikum class. Today we are going to present the Wagah model. So now I would like to, may I please introduce the Wagah model.
Wagah model is an international border between India and Pakistan. It is situated 24 kilometers
from Lahore
and 32 kilometers from Amritsar.
Wagah border, also known as Babe Azadi, which literally means get away from freedom. Now, this red line shows the border of Pakistan and India. Next slide. Next slide. Lahore. And that was the borderline. It was the distance between Pakistan and India, 24 kilometers. And yeah, also a line between Pakistan and India borderline. This is not a line of control, but border known as. That's an art gallery, and also there was a museum constructed, which is going to be open in 23rd March. And this is the unique plan where the at the great ceremony the people are sitting there. Yeah, and that's the Indian side. Next.
The border was the demarcation of the border was done in 1947 after the Red Cliff Award. It is an international border, public and transport. It is a public and transport project place. Along with it, millions of immigrants came to Wagah border in 1947. Next one. History of beating ceremony. The beating ceremony was started in 1958. It was agreed by both the governments of India and Pakistan. It shows the brotherhood as well as the rivalry between both the countries. In 2011, Indian female soldiers were also added to the border security of the Indian side, and they also performed the beating ceremony.
Yes.
Fence was constructed in 1988. It was the main purpose and the main reason behind the fence was the incident of the Sarbjit Singh, who was believed to be the Indian spy who came through to this border. At that time there was no fence, and it was a big incident in the history of both the countries. And India believed it was just a common man who crossed the border, but Pakistani soldiers and Pakistani security organizations believed that it was an Indian spy who was sent by the RA. Recently, a movie was also made by Bollywood featuring the Rajiv Buddha, Ashwarya Rai and co-stars. So this is the history. And also the fence is 15 foot higher, and height is 15 foot and its width is 12 foot. It has also a pole which have an electricity, a wire which have an electricity in this pole. The electricity provided to it is 66,000 volt, so that nobody can cross the border. Next time. And next is the culture differences. Cultural differences which are depicted at the Wagah border are many, but I can show you some of these. Here you can see Allah and tiger. Here is Allah, which is made of iron. It is on the pole of the coast of the Pakistani side. It shows that Pakistan believe in Islam. Pakistan is an Islamic country, and it got independence in the name of Islam. At the other side, it shows a vivid picture of the. These are tigers.
Statue.
It shows the Indian's mythology. And next. Urdu and English. And you can see Urdu words on the Pakistani side. On the other side, there the words are in English or in Hindi. It also shows the language of both the countries. That Pakistan official language is in Urdu, and the Indian side official and official language is Hindi or English. Both. Arabic and it is a picture of mosque, but also you can see when you go there, you can also see a lot of Urdu, Arabic and Arabic words at the walls and the other buildings, which shows that Pakistan believe in Islam and it got independence in the name of Islam. While on the other side, when you see on the Indian side, there is no such religious words. So and India is believed to be a secular. It also shows that there is no words of any religious inscriptions or any religious words. So it shows that India is a secular. Male and female segregation. When you see it, Pakistani side, male and female are segregated. Both seats separated, and it also shows the traditional conservatives. Conservative thinking. By the way, if you look at the Indian side versus Indian side, all the people are either female or male. They both sit together, and it shows that they are secular and modern in their thinking. And they have museum. Both sides have museum. Indian have opened their museum in 2010, and Pakistan is going to open the museum on 23rd of March 2017. This museum will have the inscriptions and the sources which can be helpful in history from the Indian and Pakistani subcontinent history. So next. Traditional dress. Both the soldiers from the Indian, either from Indian side or from Pakistan, wear the traditional dresses. Pakistani have their shalwar and kameez, and while the Indian soldiers dress the pant and shirts. Both the soldiers also wear turbans, which is also a traditional dress. Stalls. Governments have organized and constructed stalls there, which have coins of the historical monuments, historical places. It helps us to boost up our nationalism and patriotism. Entertainers. Both sides have obviously have entertainers who try to make people excited, and they perform different acts, different
holding a flag of Pakistan.
Holding flags.
Administration of Wagah border. Indian side, Indian borders are controlled and secured by BSF, Border Security Force. It was first. Border Security Force was first developed after 1965 war. Before BSF, there was the border was secured by the local police of the province. Then after 1965 war, they have developed BSF force. It is now currently the most efficient and wide force in the world, border force in the world. On Pakistani side, there are Pakistani Rangers. They are Pakistan and Punjab. Pakistan is under the command of Pakistan military, and they control only the international border, while the LOC is controlled by Pakistan Army. Pakistani Rangers have two main divisions. Pakistan Rangers are divided into two main. One is Pakistani Rangers Punjab side, and another is Pakistan Rangers Sindh. In Pakistan, the border between Pakistan Punjab and Indian Punjab is 540 kilometers. And it is secured by Pakistani Rangers. Then it comes to the immigration and customs. It is in Pakistani side customs building. Here, when the logistic camps and other men, when the immigrants came, they had to process here. They have to grant visa clearance and other clearance. Then have to pass to the immigration. Samjhota Express. This was started in 1978. First time, Samjhota means accordance, other it also means that they have some kind of and it is under the control of PTDC. Here, if you go to Wagah, you will see a building of PTDC, Pakistan Tourism Development Corporation, Samjhota Express, and Samjhota Express, Dosti Bus, and other the immigration are facilitated by PTDC. They have their motels, hotels, which have 4-room motels in Wagah border, where you can stay for the night. Dosti Bus service was started in 1998. It was first they have to reach to their final destination, but due to no security threats and terrorism from both sides, Wagah border is the last checkpoint. And from Pakistan side, you have to reach Wagah, and from then you cross the border by foot, and there you have to go by another bus. It is the cross border terminal Wagah Agency, National Logistics Corporation. It is a terminal here, logistics and trade occur through this trade center. But if you go to the Wagah border, the main gate is not used for trade. There another gate is installed, which is called trade gate. From that gate, trade route is called. There you have to unload the trucks and all the components, and then you have to check. After checking by the National Logistics Terminal, the cross border terminal, you have to be given. ANF, Anti-Narcotic Force. Along with custom officials, there is a very small building of Anti-Narcotic Force. They have to check that no material which are harmful, which are in case, which are drugs, cannot be imported and export. In 2012, about 20 tons of narcotics were caught and were burned on the border.